As your National Gallery enters its third century, here's a look at what it has achieved over the last 200 years.
April 1824, the House of Commons votes to create our first national collection of paintings, and the National Gallery is born.
38 paintings are acquired from the John Julius Angustine collection, and on 10th of May, 1824, the first National Gallery opens at 100 Pall Mall, Angustine's former home.
The house soon gets overcrowded after more paintings are generously given. The larger building is needed. Trafalgar Square is chosen for the new home.
Designed by William Wilkins, the new National Gallery, situated in the heart of London, aims to bring art to everyone.
Much British art is acquired alongside European paintings, with the gallery receiving a most generous bequest from the celebrated painter Turner in 1856, including many masterpieces by Turner himself.
The gallery continues to grow. 1876 sees a new suite of 8 ornate rooms, including the octagon room designed by Edward M. Barry.
And in 1896, Sunday opening begins, which allows everyone to enjoy the paintings 7 days a week.
July 1914, the world is at war. Threats of aerial bombardment over London mean 675 paintings are removed during the global conflict, with some hidden in Aldwych Underground Station.
More paintings arrive. In 1917, the Impressionists join the collection, followed by the nation's first Van Gogh in 1924.
In 1934, the gallery appoints a scientific advisor, laying the foundations for a world-leading scientific department and the conservation work that takes place today.
Electric lighting is installed in the gallery in 1935. The building can stay open after dark, and working people can enjoy the collection more easily.
During the Second World War, the collection is scattered across England and Wales, and is eventually hidden in Manod, Ice Lake Mine in North Wales.
As the paintings move out for safekeeping, the gallery continues as a cultural hub for London and the world, and renowned pianist Meyer Hess moves in and performs regular concerts.
Every month, a painting is brought back to Trafalgar Square for display to boost public morale.
In 1974, the gallery forms the country's first learning program dedicated to schools.
The gallery continually changes. New spaces open, old spaces are reconfigured.
In 1991, the building expands again, with Her Majesty the Queen opening the Sainsbury Wing, featuring new galleries and exhibition spaces.
Your National Gallery continues to flourish and grow through the support of the government, the Art Fund, and the kindness and vision of numerous supporters.
And most importantly, the daily generosity of the public.
And remains a free space for everyone, everywhere.
Bringing people and paintings together.
My favorite painting would be a tiger in a tropical storm. I think all the like different perspective is very like nice and beautiful.
My name's Michael Palin. I think Turner's a genius and I love his work. And my favorite painting was painted in 1844. It's called Rain, Steam, Speed.
My love of art really came from my dad. When I saw this picture, it gave me that feeling, and I think I've been looking for it since I was young.
My favorite painting is The Ballet Dancer by Degas. I love him. I love his paintings.
And it's a world of your choosing. So you can walk amongst the rooms and just pick something that's special to you, and then you can just drift off.
My name is Jacqueline Wilson. I absolutely love the National Gallery. I've chosen The Umbrellas by Pierre-Auguste Renoir, painted in the 1880s.
I love the space, the fact that it's free, the fact that you can wander around for almost hours without running out of things to look at.
I would say that my favourite painting is The Lilies by Monet. And the reason it's my favourite is because my mother loved Monet, and she used to bring us here when we were children and tell us all about how he painted it with a long paintbrush.
The paintings really caught my eyes, and so I came with some friends, and I actually lost my friends. I'll have to find them later on. I just got completely involved in the paintings from various periods.
I always used to come past here at night time in my clubbing days. I always used to wonder at the beauty of the building and what is inside.
To me, it was always about seeing the world through somebody else's eyes.
Hello, I'm Gabriele Finaldi, the director of the National Gallery in London. As we celebrate our 200th anniversary, I invite you to be part of this ongoing story. Children and families, scholars, tourists, and art lovers, and all those who explore our collections and exhibitions online from afar. The National Gallery belongs to all of us. It makes the great art of the past present to us. It enables us to experience works of remarkable beauty and skill, to learn, to enjoy, to wonder, to be more connected to each other. It's my hope as director to continue to share the legacy of the People's Gallery with you. Wouldn't it be wonderful if the next 200 years were as amazing as the last 200?